In this video, we're going to learn how to join a Windows 10 computer into a Windows 2016 Server Active Directory domain. So we're starting off on the domain controller just so we can double check our IP settings so we can make sure that we can communicate with our domain controller before we begin. So let's go to TCP IP version 4, and we can see the IP address of our domain controller is 192.168.0.1. So we want to make sure our DNS points to that on our client, which is a Windows 10 computer. So let's go here to our Windows 10 client, the same place. We're going to go to the Network and Sharing Center, and then we're going to go to Change Adapter Settings, Properties, and then we'll go to version 4, and there it is. Make sure it's 192.168.0.1. You also want to make sure that the IP address you're using for your client or your Windows 10 computer is on the same subnet. So it's going to have to be 192.168.0 also. But it can't share the same last IP address. Only one of each computer can do that. So we're good there. So now we can go ahead and double check that the name of our computer is set correctly. So let's go back to our control panel and go down to where it says System and make sure the name is correct. Now, in this case, it says it's the default Windows name. So we want to change that to be the name Client. So go ahead and type in Client. And at the same time, we can also join it to be the domain as a workstation. So we'll put in the name of our domain, widgetllc.internal. Click OK. And we should get a pop-up saying, what's the username and password? And there it is. Click OK. And now it says, welcome to the domain. So if for some reason you don't get that, then there's a few reasons why that could be. So let's take a look at that. I'll just choose restart later. Let's go back to our All Control Panel Items and go to Network and Sharing Center. Change adapter settings and go back to our properties of our network card. In many cases, the IP version 6 gets ahead of the IP version 4. And since we didn't set the IP version 6 and we don't have a DHCP server for IP version 6, then it causes problems and says it can't find the domain. So we'll go ahead and uncheck IP version 6, but only on the client. Leave it running on the server, on the domain controller. So that's one reason why it could be. Another reason would be that if you're using a virtual machine, such as we are here, and in this case we're using VMware, but this is the same whether you're using VirtualBox or Hyper-V, whatever it is, you want to make sure that the networks are all matching. So we want to go to the virtual machine settings, and then we're going to go to the network adapter, and in this case it says that it's on NAT. So you want to make sure that both of them are set to NAT, both the server and the client. Now, if you're using VirtualBox, you'll want to set them both to internal. And if you want to use a Hyper-V, you're going to want to set them to external. So they all have their own different ways of communicating with each other. So make sure that both the client and the server are set to the same thing. All right, so now that that's done, we'll go ahead and restart our client. And when we come back in, after it restarts, we're going to want to log in using the domain credentials instead of the local workstation credentials as we did when we booted into the client. So when we booted into the client, we logged in as a local administrator. Now we're going to log in as a domain administrator. And our client is rebooted. Let's click on Other User instead of the user that we logged into in with last time. And let's put in Widget LLC / administrator. And then we'll use our domain administrator password. And now we're logging in as the domain administrator. Now, even if you're not logging in as the domain administrator, you can log in as any domain user and from there gain access to any of the shared resources that you have access to as far as an access control list in the shared and security tabs of any shared files and folders. If you log in locally to the computer, as we did before we joined the domain, then you're just going to have access to the local computer and not to any of the shared resources on the server. Now we're logged into the domain, but you can confirm that simply by going to a command prompt and typing, who am I? And we can see we're logged in as the domain / administrator.